What's happening, man? Boss Golf back with another update slash topic video about Dragon Ball Fighters, and oh my goodness, man. So I had to talk about this because I seen it. I was gonna make a video the other day about some stuff that was data mined on the PC version of this game, but I wanted to wait a little bit until we either got information, more information about this, or until more people started talking about it to kind of get a okay, this is kind of confirmed, because, you know, people can data mine things and whatnot, but not more than often. When stuff is data mined, that's the stuff that is going to 100% be in the game. But sometimes that can either be changed or it can be false information. A few things that I wanted to talk about was some new modes that are getting ready to come in the future for Dragon Ball Fighters called Z Union and Z League. Now, in Dragon Ball Fighters, when you go into the main lobby, you'll notice that there are two lobby areas. There are two areas: the Kame House, the Kami House, however you want to pronounce it, Master Roshi's Island, and then West City. And they're just empty. When I first played the game, I thought that these areas were just there to kind of like extra areas just for people to chill, even though I didn't know why they would. It would make sense that these would be for extra stuff, but at first I was like, oh, these are just areas to chill, you know, blah blah blah, yada yada. It didn't cross my mind at the time that these would be later added on. I kind of, something at the back of my head was like, there's probably going to be add-ons, but you know me, like I wanted to deny this shit. So the things that are coming for these new areas are supposed to be Z Union and Z League. And going in a little bit about the two, Z Union is basically kind of like a gathering for fans of specific characters in the game. And I'm reading off information, and I will post the info in the link in the description box down below, but I'm just kind of paraphrasing here. Z Union is supposed to be kind of like basically for hardcore fans of a certain character. So I'll take, for example, I like Beerus. So if I really like Beerus and it was another group that really, really, really liked Beerus, basically we would get together and like we would form kind of like a clan or a team or whatever, and that would be our shit. And so they'd have like monthly event. It kind of pairs into the Z Leagues. So Z Unions is basically, how can I explain this shit? Like with Injustice 2, excuse me, I'm like all over the place because I want to get to what I want to talk about later in this video. Like Injustice 2, where Injustice 2 has kind of like the thing where you pair up with the league battles, where you pair up, make certain leagues and shit like that, and you go against other leagues to try and get to the top of the list and win things like that. That's what this whole Z Union and Z League is supposed to be about. The only difference is with Z Union, you basically pick a character. So if I wanted to pick Beerus, like let's say I really like Beerus, I'd go and I pick Beerus, and I'd be under that certain Z Union, and I'd go out and I'd play battles and I'd win certain items catered to Beerus. So like I'm going to assume, this wasn't said in the thing, but I'm going to assume this means like lobby headers, lobby characters, lobby avatars, cut character colors, different things like that. Maybe we'd get like special costumes. I don't know what this means, but as far as like the items we earn. But that's what happens inside of your Z Union. And then you will go out and you'd have competitions against other Z Unions. So like if somebody, like let's say my group Beerus wanted to go against a bunch of Piccolo fanboys, we would go against them inside of the Z League, which happens like every month. And this is like an ongoing thing, and this is supposed to be added to the game in the future, because this is what was data mined in the game about a couple of days ago. When more information drops about that, like I said, I'll talk more about it, but that's pretty much what Z Union Z League is. Z Union is like if you're a fan of a certain character within the game, or maybe in the series in general, you go and that be your clan. And then you go out and do battles and y'all try to get as much points, get as many wins, and try to get to the top of the leaderboard during the Z Leagues for your Z Union. So that's what that is. And also, there's something that was data mined. Before I get to talk about this last part, there was something that was data mined called raid battles. And basically, raid battles, it's, if you're familiar with Xenoverse 2, which I'm not, I didn't get the chance to play Xenoverse 2, at least the full game. I played the beta, or I played the customization of the beta. But the raid battles are the same as they were in Xenoverse 2. And basically what I'm getting here, it says players will expect to cross paths with the fiercest foes in raid battles and are expected to train up and prepare, and it will be possible to join forces with other players and take this Titan down. So basically, kind of like, I'm getting getting Injustice vibes from the Z Union, Z League, and raid battles. Basically, you form a group, you go out and compete against other groups, and then there's also basically boss battles that you can team up with other people online, especially since there's the 3v3 mode, which is online only, and so you can pair up with two other people and y'all can go and take down this like super boss that's supposed to be difficult in training. And it says train up and prepare for this, so one or two things, like you're actually going to need to know your shit about Dragon Ball FighterZ and the tech and how to actually play this game, or they're going to incorporate items that allow you to level up and different things like that in order to be able to take this boss down. And so, like I said, I'm getting Injustice 2 vibes because that was the most recent game that I've played that has had something along the lines of what this is, and I can't remember right now what the proper name is called with inside of Injustice 2. But that's it for the new modes that are coming in: Z Union, Z League, and raid battles. And then finally, I want to talk about something that has been popping up the most out of all the information we've been hearing about this game, as far as data mined, as far as leaks and things like that, which is the DLC characters. Now, I lost count of how many times I've fucking seen this list, but the very first time I did not want to be this shit to be true. But according to this data mine, and especially since we've been constantly seeing this shit from, I will call them very reliable sources, because like the sites and the people that post this shit, usually they post very credible information. And when they do, it ends up being true later along in the future. The DLC characters for this game. Remember, there are supposed to be 8 characters in the Season 1 pass that are supposed to be DLC for now. This game has been data mined, and the DLC characters have been revealed as far as who's supposed to be in this game. And this is also, the people who data mined this also data mined that the new modes Z Union and Z League were going to be in there, and the raid battles. Here is the supposed DLC character list. Please take this shit with a grain of salt. Treat it as a fucking rumor, because until Bandai Namco says with their lips that these are the characters, these aren't the fucking characters. But once again, you have to take into consideration, we've seen this shit, heard about it. I'm gonna exaggerate the fuck out of this 1,000 times over, and usually when shit like that happens, it's gonna be a thing. The 8 characters that were data mined from this game: Broly, Bardock, Zamasu, Vegito, Cooler, Ranger, Android 17. I'm assuming that's the Android 17 from Super. Base Goku and Base Vegeta. I'm gonna repeat that shit again. The 8 characters that were data mined that are supposed to be DLC characters inside of this game are Bardock, Broly, Zamasu, Vegito, Cooler, Android 17, Ranger Android 17, I'm assuming from Super, Base Goku, and Base Vegeta. I'm going to say this, and then I'm going to end the video. Out of all these characters that I'm actually cool with, and I get, y'all know how I feel about, at least the ones that have been watching me for a while, y'all know how I feel about DLC, loot boxes, and all this other shit. But also my philosophy, my thing about it is, if you're going to have it in the goddamn game, at least make it to where it doesn't seem like straightforward bullshit. Make it work to where, okay, you either want to put this in the game for some reason, or there are higher ups above you that really need this, or quote unquote need this inside of the game, in order for to be able to market it to everybody. Just make it fucking work. Make it be a balance. Make it be an actual give and take instead of just a fucking take all, leave none type of situation. Out of all these characters that's inside of this list, Broly, Bardock, maybe Vegito. I'm gonna say Vegito. Vegito's cool because I should have expected any type of fusion character, either Gogeta or Vegito. Gogeta or Vegito. So Bardock, Broly, Vegito, Cooler are the characters that I'm cool with outside of this list of the 8 characters that are supposed to be coming up in the future. And according to this list here, it seems like there might be at least 2 characters coming out at a time during this whole season 1 deal. These other characters, and y'all already motherfucking know, first of all, Zamasu, because that's the least damaging one, although I question Zamasu because based on my little bit of knowledge of Super, Zamasu is supposed to be Goku Black. Like, that's supposed to be Zamasu's spare body inside of Super. And later on, they fuse inside of the series, and all this shit happens with Zamasu and all this other shit. Like I said, I watched 2 clips and I read little information. But still, if that's the case, why not have had an install Super for Goku Black inside of the game as Zamasu inside of the body? You already have him with kind of like a tag assist during one of Goku Black's Kamehameha waves. Why not have them fuse within inside of the thing? This is the shit that I'm questioning. I'm not, there's no point of asking the fucking companies anymore because they've already, this shit possibly is already happening. Like that makes no sense to me. Zamasu, he could have easily been an install super or a transformation, basically. For those that don't know what install supers are in fighting games, he could have basically been a transformation for Goku Black. If this is what I'm assuming it is. If it's just, it says in quotation marks, Zamasu Fuse. If this shit is just Zamasu by itself, that's going to be a dick slap. And, kind of the same dick slaps going into this next one. Android 17. Now this one, I didn't expect this shit. I really didn't. I already knew they were trolling, considering the fact they put 2/3 of the damn gang inside of the game, which are Android 17 and 16, Android 18 and 16, and all of them rode together during the whole Cell Saga for the little bit of time that they were chilling before all the shit went down. Like, if anything, 17 should have already been in there. Now, I get that it's cool that it is a cool feature that a lot of these characters have basically their own tag assist and have the characters to come in and do something, but this is literally a dick slap in the face to all the people who were either asking for 17 or wanted, really was expecting him in the game. Like, he's just as much of an important character as Android 18 and 16. If anything, like, I really did not expect Tuxin to be in the game. I still don't know his importance in the story. I haven't got that far. Please don't fucking spoil it for me. But, yeah, it blows my mind that they would prioritize 16 in the game as a main roster character over 17. But that's, that thinking about it from a non-business standpoint, when you actually think about this shit, you can see why they'd want to do it. The same reason they'd want to do it with Broly and Vegito and Bardock. These are characters that people would really want inside the game. And then the last two, these aren't even cock teases. These are really what the fucks. I don't understand this shit from a business standpoint. I don't understand this shit at all because this makes absolutely no sense. And if anybody buys this shit, they either don't know shit or don't give a shit about Dragon Ball Z or literally throwing money at this company for no fucking reason. Just because base Goku and base Vegeta, I talked about this in the pre- I'm tossing shit. I talked about this shit in the previous video. I don't care if you're not a Dragon Ball Z fan. I don't care if you don't give a shit about Akira Toriyama or anything that he's ever made. If you pay for this shit, you have no type of fucking brain inside of your skull, because I want you to sit and think about this shit. They put Super Saiyan Goku inside of this game. They put Super Saiyan Vegeta inside of this game. Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Blue, Goku and Vegeta inside of this game. And they're supposed to be. Once again, we could take this shit with a grain of salt, but we've seen this shit over 5 times in the course of the advertisement before this game came out, and it's been data mined that it's inside of the game. Base Goku and base Vegeta. That's like if I take a Street Fighter game and I throw all of the extra versions of Ryu and Ken and Sakura and Dan and whoever else has evil or extra or super versions, and then for some fucking reason making actual base Ryu and base Ken a DLC character. Now, you know they're already going to charge, like, what, $5 to $7 for these characters, and people will be like, oh, well, they're this much with the season pass. No, fuck that. That makes no sense. For people that don't like Dragon Ball Z, for people that do, like, think about this shit. Would you actually fucking pay for base Ryu, base Akuma in a Street Fighter game if they only, for some reason, threw an evil Ryu and Shin Akuma? Would that make any sense to you? Would that make any sense to anybody? How does that make sense? Like, think about it, if they had a fucking Tekken game and had Devil Jin as a main character roster, and then came in later and said, hey, throw in Jin for as a DLC. That's a dick slap to the actual people who give a shit about Tekken. That's a dick slap to anybody who wants to play the fucking game. Why would you do something like this? You know what? I will even go as far as to say, a lot of this roster for DLC is actually okay, because it was to be expected. We live in the age, once again, of DLC, loot boxes, and apparently shitty business practices when it comes to fucking video game advertisement and business practices. I said that already. Fuck. That's how confuzzled I am. But base Goku and base Vegeta makes absolutely no sense. Even if for some reason they did some kind of extraordinary super, or Goku had an actual fucking spirit bomb or went Kaioken, it still wouldn't make any fucking sense. Because that's like having the game's mascot without the mascot. I can make all these other analogies and metaphors about, oh, compared to Street Fighter or anything, blah, 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 yada, yada. That's like having the main game and the mascot that's supposed to be the mascot of the game not being in the game, and then you having to pay for that character later. You want another fucking metaphor, analogy, whatever you want to call it. What if you played a fucking Sonic game? You played a goddamn Sonic game and they had Super Sonic as the main roster character and then came out later. What if Sonic Forces did some shit like that? What if they had Super Sonic as the main character? As the main character playable roster inside of the game, and then later on came out and said, hey, we're gonna charge you $5, or we're gonna put it in the season pass for Sonic to be playable. How many people wouldn't be shaking their fucking heads? How does this, oh shit. This every time I see this shit, I looked at it the last few times and I was like, this shit's not gonna be true. I keep throwing it outside of my brain because I'm like, this shit's not, they're not actually gonna go through with this. But after seeing this shit almost over 5 times within the entire year that this game was being advertised, and people are saying, oh, it is gonna happen, it's being confirmed, the game is out and it's still being, the game's been data mined and it's being confirmed? Base Goku and Vegeta. They doing, and the only reason I can think because it makes no sense any other way, is they're doing this shit for people who aren't aware of the Dragon Ball Z fan base or don't give a shit. Well, once again, maybe somebody just was like, oh, fucking DLC, season passes. Yeah, I'll pay for that. But think about that shit. If a game had a game, the game's main mascot was not in the game, and then later on put in the game as DLC, what? What? Fucking Gears of War without Marcus Fenix or Marcus Fenix's son. Fucking Halo without Master Chief, whether it be the male or female, as long as Master Chief is in the fucking game. What? That'd be like a goddamn Madden game, a fucking football game with the you know how they like, they have the Madden games and they advertise the teams on the front cover and they have that main team on the front cover. Let's say it was like the Falcons or the Ravens, whoever the fuck is your favorite team, and they had them on the front cover. And then for some reason that team wasn't inside of the game and then later on put it in as a DLC? That's the only reason I think of. Because they're doing this shit for people who don't know about Dragon Ball Z. I'm probably seeing this and probably saying, oh, well, they did such a good damn job of, they said did such a good damn job of the roster and making everybody look cool. Maybe, you know, maybe these characters actually, you know, they do good. Maybe they're top tier characters. And that would be some shit if these two characters actually happen to be the top tier characters of the fucking game. I don't get it. That's my opinions on this. I can't say anymore. I don't want to say anymore. Otherwise, nigga, I'd be breathing too goddamn hard and I'd be going in circles. But I just, when I look at this list, Android 17, yes, is bullshit. Zamasu, only reason I don't like, I'm not as enthusiastic, I guess you would say, about that one is because I really don't know too much about Super. I don't know too much about Super. And to be honest, he's not, even if I knew about Super, I still have other, like, there's still other characters within the Dragon Ball universe that I'd be more excited about. And in Android 17, yes, that's a dick slap, but, you know, if I really would have said, thought about it, I was like, okay, they probably would have pulled that shit, even though it is, that's just not worse than the fucking game's mascots not being in the game, and now we have to pay for this shit. If this is true. If this is true. I'm going to say it one more time. If this shit is true. Like, I'll be sitting telling you motherfuckers. It's not like I'll be wanting to come on here and rage for no goddamn reason. I don't. I wasn't even going to make this fucking video about the Z Union in the Z League. I was just gonna wait till we got more information, a confirmation. But I felt like I seen this base Goku shit and base Vegeta shit again, and I'm looking at this like, y'all are actually about to do this. This is actually about to be a fucking thing. This is actually about to be a goddamn thing. And if you think that it's not, like, there, fuck, this has already gone on too long. One more thing, and then I am gone. Excuse me if this is dragged on too long, but y'all know me and my shit. Especially when I'm on a roll about talking about shit. If you've unlocked all the lobby characters inside of the game, and there happens to be 54. I haven't done that yet. I haven't got all the characters. Especially, I don't have the Zenny to do the whole loot box system. So, there are supposed to be 54 lobby characters. Out of all those characters inside of the game, you'll find that some of these characters that are inside of the DLC list that I named off are actually lobby characters, including Base Goku, Base Vegeta, I think Android 17 and Cooler and Bardock are lobby avatars inside of this thing. And so, it's like the avatars that are inside of the game are either playable in some way, even if they're a tag assist character, they're either playable in some way, or they're actually on the main roster. And so that's something else. That's something else that needs that should be thought about within the game. I don't know. I'm out of this bitch. Let me know what y'all think about this in the comment section down below. Once again, please, oh my God, take the, even though with these rumors and these data mines, please take this shit with a grain of salt, because companies can change their mind just like that. I'm no longer accepting, oh, we can't do that anymore. After in the Storm series, CC2 said they wouldn't be able to do something, and twice they changed it. And especially after Tekken 7 recently, they said they wouldn't be able to do something that they said it was impossible, and then later came out and said, oh, we're gonna give you guys a free update that actually changes and fixes that. And now that I come to think about it, both of those games were produced by Bandai Namco. So just take that with a grain of salt, and be careful when you go out and share this information, and think about this shit when it's out there. I'm not this bitch. There's nothing more I can say about this, except if there is a new video or a new list that comes out explaining more, shows this shit again. If it's just showing it again, saying, oh, these characters could be confirmed, I won't talk about it again. That's my promise. I won't talk about this shit again unless it's actually confirmed. If it's confirmed and we see that these characters are being like actually input in the game, I'm gonna fucking talk about it. But I think I've said everything I need to say for now, until there's 100% confirmation. They're showing files and shit like that of models that are supposed to be in the game. But once again, even with this being right in front of my face, I'm gonna take all this shit real easy. I'm gonna take it. I don't even fucking know. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comment box down below. If you're new to the goddamn channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button, and also hit the bell next to the subscribe button, so that way when I get any more information about Dragon Ball FighterZ, you all will be the first to know, especially if it's important. It's something that should be talked about among video game fans alike, not just fighting game fans or not just the anime fans, but especially now that the bridges have been crossed, is for all of you motherfuckers out there. So I'm out of this bitch. You already know what to do, man. Make sure I keep them schlongs on, them clips tight, and I'll see you so the hoes on the flip one. Peace.